Why can I not get it open? I opened it up yesterday. Are they cousins today or are they... Yeah. They are at least the same family, so that's good. I think I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille. Well, hello my beauties and good morning and welcome to my channel. I thought let's do a get ready with me, kind of chatty style, I hope so. And play with some new goodies, because yesterday I was just spoiled. Let me put on some primer on my face first, so I can kind of let that sink in. It's the Revolution Pro Hydra Matte that I'm going to use today. But yeah, so yesterday, let's start at the beginning. I mentioned in a few videos about my Black Friday haul and that my husband bought me some Kaleidos palettes. Well, they came in yesterday. So that was really, really cool. So as you saw by the title, I think you saw at least, I'm going to play with one today. But also, guys, I have the best subscribers ever. Some have even become friends, which is something that I never thought would happen, basically, if I'm being completely honest. But maybe you can see her there. I have a mini-me. I put it on my Instagram yesterday when I got it. This is so freaking cool. One of you made her. I don't really know if you mind me saying your name, so I will not. I did tag you on Instagram, but this is so freaking cool. She crocheted it, and I have a raven on my shoulder, or she kind of called it a dead chicken as well. She even put my tattoos that I have on the side of my head. The only thing is, I'm not silver anymore, but I will get that color eventually. So yeah, so it's so, so cool. And yeah, she gave it a base like this, so I can stand her up. So of course she needs to go here. And then this I needed to put here, because my son wanted it to. This is where he works. So yeah, this was in his Christmas box. That I don't know if it is only here that happens, but basically if you work you get a Christmas box around this time. So yeah, there's that, and that was in it. It was a very nice box, by the way. So yeah, I thought let's get ready. I also got a lippy. Maybe you can see the box here. So yeah, there's that. I got the... Let's get them out. See, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to bring my sticky tape. But yeah. So I got the Futurism 1, the sci-fi green. I got the 4 VR Neon and the 5 Electro Turquoise. However, I really, really want to play with this one today, the sci-fi green. So I'm going to do that. And I actually had an idea as well for... The what's it called again? Wow, it's early. Can you tell? It is so. I cannot even describe how it feels. This, it's smooth. It feels luxurious. It's just perfect. But yeah. So what I want to do actually, this is what she looks like, and here you have that. I want to sticker it or glue it. I'm going to cut it up basically, and then I'm going to glue it there with some sticky tape so I can see the shade names. And I actually don't understand why people haven't thought of that before. I could also glue it on top of the mirror, because I don't use the mirror anyway. But that is what I'm going to do. I kind of get why they didn't want to put the shade names underneath, because it would, yeah, I agree, it would kind of, I don't know, not work. So yeah, but I think I'm going to glue it here on top of the mirror. Again, I'm not going to use it anyway, and if I do, I can see through it. And again, I don't get why people have not done that. I need to swatch your people. So I'm going to swatch. Let me put you there. I'm going to start with the brown, and I'm going to swatch that way. Clean bare arm. Wow. Wow. I did not really see that coming, and I do really understand what they mean. I know that swatches aren't everything, but Let me show you how I swatched. What I did is I have the shade here. I don't have a lot of pressure and I did this. Two circles. And then you get this. So yeah, this one did not swatch very well, but that's probably me. Oh Lord, guys. So yeah, I'm going to play with that one today. But first, do I want to put on my face first? Sure, why not? I'm rambling. I'm going to wipe it off. I am going to wear this one though, because it matches my shirt. And my son got not to pick my eyeshadow today, but he got to pick my earrings today, or at least the plugs I'm going to wear, which I'm actually in the process of making, because he didn't want them to be too big. Make my ears look big. But so what I did is I actually made these. I did make these in a smaller size because the plug that I have kind of drying on the back is 8 millimeters, but because I have these in those silicone-y things, I can wear them. So yeah, there's that. So these will be for sale as well, because I did not really wear them because they were worn inside of one of these things, you know. So yeah, I will put them up on my other Instagram, I hope today, but I'm not sure, just so you know. So yeah, the foundation I'm going to wear is the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage. If I forget to mention any stuff, it will be listed down below. I'm just going to pounce it in. I have been filming so much. I am having a lot of fun filming. And to be quite honest with you, I have been kind of uploading almost every day in December. But I don't really know if I should have. I do want to do more, if I can kind of do more than 3 videos a week in my normal schedule. But it also needs to kind of work. And because I want to grow my channel, I need to kind of reassess the videos that I do, you know? So, while I love doing multiple looks videos, and I will do multiple looks videos going forward as well, they are not my most watched videos. And I know everyone says I love tutorials, and I personally love tutorials as well. They are just not the best watched, and I cannot really figure out the videos that I should do, you know, to get more subscribers and all that. And I'm not complaining, don't get me wrong, I am growing. It is just that, I don't know, sometimes I feel like I'm making content just for me, you know, which I kind of should, because it's my channel and I need to have fun on my channel. But yeah, you know, I also want people to watch, basically. Stars Hollywood Jessica said yesterday in one of her videos, if I remember which one it was, I will link it, that she has this kind of the same amount of subscribers as I do, maybe a little bit more, I don't remember. But her watch time on her videos, or the views on her videos, are so low. And she is, and I agree with her, kind of like, why? You know, I also have 1700 and a little over 50, so 1700 and a little bit of subscribers. But if you see the views, they are pretty low, you know. Even my Let's Talk Makeup, which is actually my best watched video, usually have 300 views, 400 views, and that is still a lot, but compared to how many subscribers I have, it is not, you know. So yeah, and I know that is across the board. I can see people with, I don't know, Annette for instance. She is almost at 30,000. And she has maybe, I don't know, 3k views on her videos, which is a lot. But compared to how many subscribers she has, it is not, you know? So I cannot figure out for the life of me why that is. Is it because YouTube isn't pushing the videos? Is it because people are just not interested? Am I making the videos too long? Am I making them too short? Do I ramble too much? Do I not show enough? You know, let me know. Give me feedback, please. Well, I want to do... this was my One Drop Coverage by Catrice, by the way. And all the makeup will be listed down below. Did I already say that? I hope so. Yeah, I want to make content that I like, obviously, but I also want to make content that you watch and that you like to watch, you know? And I know that my core audience kind of tries to watch me always, you know, and I know that it's not always possible. And that is also the reason that I kind of don't want to upload every day, because I can feel now there. The reason that I am continuing to upload as much as I am doing now is simply because of the fact that I want to get videos out now. And those are my favorites. I yesterday filmed five videos actually. I filmed the first look with the winter palette from 5050 Makeup. And I also filmed my 2019 favorites. And instead of doing it in one video, which would have been a video of about an hour, I split it up. So now I have four videos, and for me, I can then kind of give a little bit more information in the video, you know, instead of feeling that I need to rush because otherwise the video is too long. It's the same with tutorials or looks. I don't want to make them too long. My Nomad video, five looks, was about half an hour, which for five looks I think is very, very reasonable. But yeah, I don't know, maybe I need to do voiceovers or something along those lines. I don't know, people. I don't really know what it is. I don't think they kind of need an eyeshadow base, but I'm going to use it anyway. I'm going to put it on now, which is going to be my Catrice one. I really fell in love with this one, to be quite honest with you. I haven't used it in quite a while, because I kind of wanted to use what everyone was using, you know, and try different stuff and see what was better. But to be quite honest with you, I really, really like this primer. Just saying. The only downside of this primer is it doesn't give you any coverage, so there's that. And also, when I see other people's videos, I don't know, Smoky Glow for instance, you know, she has some really interesting views on stuff. And I don't know, I always kind of feel like I don't, or not interesting enough. I don't know what it is. Maybe it's my own insecurity. Could very well be that. Let's get one of my favorite powders. I know it's going to be a little bit warmer today, so I'm going to use the Hourglass. Because I want to. I need it today. I think I'm almost out. It's so sad. Oh, I was doing this, just so you know. I know it sounded weird, but yeah. I think I am almost out, guys, and that is so saddening. Because this stuff is freakishly expensive. I'm just going to kind of set more where I know I'm going to put product. Because this foundation now actually kind of sets by itself. Oh yeah, I almost forgot. I think this video will go up first. With my new hair, or my old hair, whichever which way you look at it. Because yeah, people will probably have questions. Anyway, what happened? I did say this in a few videos, but I do know that not everyone watches the same videos. So yeah, if you are one of those who watch most of my videos, you will hear this a few times, but it is what it is. Basically, I'm going to kind of buff over it a little bit. Basically what happens is every week I need to bleach my hair if I want to keep it that silver. I need to tap out creasing, which is very annoying. I didn't pay enough attention to my under eye here before I said it. So there's that. But what was I saying again? Oh yeah, the bleaching of the hair. It is a weekly process. So I am then basically bleaching my hair for an hour. Also, I don't want to have kind of washed my hair the day before, because then it kind of hurts, you know. A lot of the time I do it, I don't know, Friday morning or something like that. But I just didn't feel like it last week, and I actually didn't feel like it this week either. So I was like, you know what, I need to shave it again anyway, because I usually do that every once in a while. So yeah, I just didn't feel like it. So I shaved it and I was like, you know what, let's kind of do a short buzz cut again and see how I like it. If I don't like it, I can always bleach it, you know. So this happened. I am going to wear this. And this is the Revolution Ruby Crush Highlighter. However, I use it as a blush. Warning, and that's you need to be very, very careful with it because it is very, very pigmented. I'm also going to wear my bronzer, so let me do the bronzer first. Okay, bronzer is on, and that was the Maybelline City Bronzer in color 200. Yes, let's do brows. So for brows, I have my Catrice Slimmatic Brow Pencil in Cool Brown and my ABH Clear Brow Gel. I'm just going to kind of see what I can do today with my brows. They're usually pretty rambunctious. So I remember the first time I had my eye on this one. This was actually the only thing from the Revolution Christmas collection that I really, really wanted. And then I saw it in store and I was like, it's mine. But the first time, I should have filmed it, because the first time I put it on, I used a brush like this, a very, very fluffy one. And I kind of did this, you know? And then I just went like that. That is not really a good idea, because this is so, so pigmented that I need to go in very, very slow. Otherwise, I kind of look like a clown. There's nothing wrong with looking like a clown, if that's your aesthetics, but it's not really the vibe I'm going for. However, I think that if you are of a darker complexion, this will be so, so pretty on you. So if you go in light, you can make it work if you are lighter. But use a fluffy brush. Don't use a dense brush. It's not a good idea. And also what kind of annoyed me, by the way, about my silver hair, although I really love the way that it looks, is the fact that I get that yellow line there, you know? And I clean it every time. It is just the bronzer, and then specifically cream bronzer, that really does a number on my hair there. Although, I do have to say that ever since I started using a bar soap, shampoo bar, I think that's how you call it, it was a lot better. So yeah, highlighter. Let me get a highlighter again, because why not? Let me get you, actually. This is one from AliExpress, from Miss Rose. It's a shimmer highlight in the color 08. It's very pretty. It's, I think, a dupe for, what is it, an Ofra one. But it's very pretty, guys. And if you use it with a fluffy brush, like for instance the one that I just used for my blush, it's softer. If you use it with a brush that is a bit more dense, it is a little bit more intense. I do kind of, it does look like I have a grayish cast though, which I actually never noticed before. Okay, let's get my blush brush that I just used and go over it with a little bit of blush. The only thing that would have made this better for me is if it was in cardboard packaging instead of plastic, because I can already tell that I'm going to wreck the packaging probably pretty soon, which is a shame because the product is amazing. Maybe that's a bit better. I don't know. It is what it is, guys. So yeah, okay, so there's that. I think I'm ready for my close-up, Mr. DeMille. Let me put on the lippy as well, because I ordered the lippy. This is the one in Infusion. And it's kind of a weird formula, because it is like, they said it, and I kind of agree, it's like the Blotted Lips from ColourPop. I only think that this one is more comfortable. Do I need a lip liner with that then? I don't think so, do I? So yeah, this is the color. Let me put it on. And it is like, I don't know, your lips, but better? I don't know. But I really like it. I really like the color as well. So yeah, there's that. Okay. Let me get my eye brushes, because it's not going anywhere, is it? So the only thing that I have left coming in from Black Friday are my refer brushes. Yeah, but that's probably going to take a while. So there's that. So yeah, my Kaleidos palette. Can I cram them all on my eyeball? I don't know. But I do know that I want the color Radioactive, which is the brownie one. That one. That's what I'm going to start with. And I'm probably going to start, I don't know where I'm going to start. But I'm going to start with it. So I'm going to go into the color Radioactive. Lightly. This is a bit kick-upy in the pan. I want to start here. Blend a bit. I don't really have a set plan. I just know I want to use this color. I like it. I'm going to bring it back, but a little bit higher. So that I have room to put other shadows underneath. Okay, I'm going to switch to my Morphe M507 and I'm going to go into the color Smog, which was this middle green for the outer corner. Oh yeah, I did want to say something about feedback. I don't know, just let me know, I don't know, if there are improvements for me to do. Maybe some video ideas you guys want to see, you know? That kind of stuff. Do you want to see more chatty videos? I know quite a few of you say that you really, really like my tutorials. And I really like doing them as well. I do have to say that almost everything, every eye look I do is kind of a tutorial. But I could do specific tutorials, I don't know, you know? Wow. Going back to that first brush again to just blend the edge a bit. I'm dipping into that green with this brush a little. What's today? Oh yeah, today's Wednesday. It's almost Christmas, people. Cute. I'm going to go back to the first color again. I'm just going to run it over. And I also want this underneath my eye, that first color. So yeah, maybe I could even, you know, let me know how you feel about my thumbnails. Is there anything that I need to change there? Do I need to change my titles up a bit maybe? Let me know, please, because I'm very, very curious. I like this. I need that, it needed a little bit higher though. So I'm switching brushes and I'm actually going into ET, which is the darker green. I need a different brush because this brush is annoying me. Is that better? Yeah, that is better. Because of the way that my eyes are shaped, I kind of don't want that, you know? So I need to cheat a little. It is a green that is a little bit more sticky, I can see. So I'm getting my Morphe M514. I'm going back into that lightest green. Just going to put a wash on top. And after that, I'm going to dip back into the first color. So is there anything else I want to talk about? I don't know. It's almost 2020 and it is just, I don't know. I remember, I'm going back into the brown. I remember, you know, the Back to the Future movies. We thought we would have flying cars by now, people. So yeah, there's that. I want the color Glamora, which is that kind of a dirty, greeny, goldy goodness. I love colors like that so much. I'm going to, usually I use a glitter primer. I'm not going to today though, because it's a first impression as well. It's dry, let's see what it does. Nice. Okay, let's spray. Where's my spray? There. Ooh, that is nice. Very pretty. I'm going to flip my brush. I'm going to go into the other shimmer, which is called Nuclear. It's going to go in the inner part. Oh, wow. Okay, let me get a brush, just blend the edge a bit. And while I'm at it, get a little bit of the black, because I haven't used it, and just plop it here. Oh, that's a very nice black to work with, by the way. It layers very, very nicely. I just took a tiny, tiny bit. Cute. Okay, eye pencil. I'm going to, I don't have a lot of time. I almost have no time, actually. I'm going to finish off this look off camera because I need to hurry it up and I cannot do that while filming. So I will be right back to show you the finished look, but I think I don't have time for falsies. I'm not sure yet. So hold on tight. Yeah. So here is the completed look. I didn't put on falsies. I know it's very, very shocking, but I just don't have the time. Well, maybe I have, but I don't want to rush. How I finished it off is I first put in the eye pencil from L'Oreal, a gel crayon in the color Rest in Khaki in my waterline. It wasn't enough for me, so I then put the shimmers there as well. So first I put in the outer part, I put that greeny one again. This one just sprayed on top of my lashes. And then in the inner part I put in this one also sprayed. And then in my inner corner I used my face highlight. Not sprayed. I could have sprayed, but I didn't. And then I finished it off with mascara, two coats of my Glam & Doll false lashes. Oh yeah, and I put in the earrings that my son wanted me to wear today because the glue is dry and I can wear them. So if you like these, I can make them in different sizes from 6 millimeter up to, what's the biggest size I have? 16, I think, millimeter. So yeah. I will leave the Instagram handle down in the description box. Raven's Ear is the name of the Kada company. Me, basically. But yeah, guys, this was it. This was my first impression. Get ready with me using the Kaleidos Futurism 1 and being a little bit chatty about it. So yeah, let me know down below what you think of the look, if you have the palette, but also, as I asked, give me some feedback. Are there things that I can improve on? Are there things that I can change? Do you want me to do specific content? Do you want me to do more tutorials? Do you want me to do less tutorials but more chatty? Do you want me to do more of this? Let me know down in the comment section below. For now, I'm going to thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.